There exists only the present instant. A now, which always and without end is itself new. There is no yesterday, nor any tomorrow, but only now, as it was 1,000 years ago, and as it will be 1,000 years hence. People who dwell in God dwell in the eternal now. God cannot know itself without me. Existence itself stands in need of nothing, for it lacks nothing, whereas everything else needs it, because outside of it there is nothing. Nothingness stands in need of existence, as a sick man lacks health and is in need. Health has no need of a sick man. To want nothing, therefore, characterizes the highest perfection, is fullest and purest existence. Everything is meant to be lost, that the soul may stand in unhampered nothingness. The shell must be cracked apart if what is in it is to come out. For if you want the kernel, you must break the shell. And therefore, if you want to discover nature's nakedness, you must destroy its symbols. And the farther you get in, the nearer you come to its essence. When you come to the One, that gathers all things up into itself. There you must stay. The soul in which this birth is to take place must keep absolutely pure and must live in noble fashion, quite collected and turned entirely inward. Not running out through the five senses into the multiplicity of creatures. But all interned and collected. And in the purest part, there is God's place. He disdains anything else. The soul is scattered abroad among her powers and dissipated in the action of each. Thus, her ability to work inwardly is enfeebled, for a scattered power is imperfect. Do not imagine that your reason can grow to the knowledge of truth, of God. Whoever possesses God in their being has the presence in a divine manner. And it shines out to them in all things. For them, all things taste of God. And in all things, it is God's image that they see. It is a certain and necessary truth that one who resigns their will wholly to God will catch God and bind God. So that God can do nothing but what that person wills.